Hi, Kerry here from My Cloud Bookkeeping. I work with small businesses and entrepreneurs to help them to keep their books in order using QuickBooks Online so that they have access to up-to-the-minute reports to manage the business and cash flow every day. Today, we're going to be looking at how do you record credit card fees. So if you're using Stripe or a different payment processor to collect payments from your customers, quite often what happens is when you get the money into the bank or it appears on the bank feed from the connection to the bank, the amount that you receive is different to the amount you've recorded in the invoice and the sales receipt. And the question becomes, how do you match up the deposit without duplicating the transaction, of course, and keep an eye on those credit card fees? So we're going to walk through the steps so that you can record the fees separately and record the full payment from your customers. So to walk through the first method, and this is my preferred method where it works, we're going to pop to the bank feed. And I can see here there's an ATM deposit for $480. Okay, ATM deposit is not a great description for something that would have come in with credit card fees deducted from it. So let's just pretend this says Stripe deposit right here and now, because I don't want to confuse you, but I'm in the sample company, so I can't change this description, unfortunately. So we are now looking at our Stripe deposit of $480, and we know that this relates to an invoice we sent to one of our clients, and they've paid us with Stripe. So we're going to open this up here and click Find Match, and this will give us a list of any invoices or payments that have come in. And we happen to know that this one is from Kathy. So if we select here this $500, it shows that she's only paid $480 because that's the amount we've received. But we know, in fact, she paid in full, and of course, credit card fees have been deducted. So I'm going to type $500 here. We can see there's a difference of $20 shows up. So we're going to choose to resolve this difference, scroll down, and we have the option to choose a category. Now I have another video, links up on the right there, on how to set up credit card fees as an account and an item so that you can use it for a category. So here we have our credit card fees, and what we're going to do is we're going to type minus $20. Credit card fees are typically exempt from tax, so that's what I'm going to use, exempt purchases, there it is. And now you can see that the total of this transaction is $480. So we received $480 in our bank, we're applying $500 to completely close this invoice from Kathy, it's fully paid, and we're recording $20 in credit card fees. So when we click save for this, if we go to have a look to see how much Kathy owes us, it's going to show up as nothing. So let's have a quick look in there. See, nothing owing from Kathy. The $500 is fully paid. If we have a look in our profit and loss, where are we? Reports. We have credit card fees of $20. So this is a really nice, clean way to do it where everything is recorded accurately. So the second method involves adjusting the invoice or the sales receipt to include the credit card fee. Now, this is not my preferred option. If your customer has online access to their invoices and sales, I don't know if you've noticed or not, but down the bottom it'll show how many times they've looked at it, or they may grab it to look at it again to download it if there is an audit or some reason. So they would see that, and it wouldn't agree to what they were sent in the first place. I do use this method for sales receipts that are not sent out. So if I have recurring sales receipts that I'm just entering in that people don't receive, then sometimes I'll do that. So that's what I've done in this case. I've got a sales receipt that we're going to go and have a look at. So let's have a quick look in here. I have this sales receipt for Adwin where I've billed him $2,000 for something. And I've looked on the bank feed and I've checked my Stripe report or whatever, and I've seen that the credit card fees were $200, which is quite a high number, I think we'll all agree. But anyway, that's what I've decided to do. So I have $200 of Stripe fees here. So then I take these off, the sales receipt total becomes $1,800. I'm still getting my income through as $2,000, and the credit card fees expense is going to be $200. So we'll save and close this one, and we'll pop back to our bank feed. Now we can see here it's matched. If it was still at $2,000, it would not have matched. We could have gone through that find match scenario and resolved, which I would have preferred, but I wanted to show you a different way to do it. So here we go, it's matched, and we can click match. And if you're still with me, let's just go and have a quick look at this report here.
so that we can then see that our credit card fees are now $220. We've recorded the $20 from Kathy and the $200 from Adwin.
It's important to keep an eye on those credit card fees. They do add up quite quickly. They're one of the costs of doing business for sure. And if they're improving your efficiency and they're part of a wonderfully organized workflow, then that's great. But if you're not getting the efficiency and you have the high costs, you might want to look at some other options. And there are many different options out there, a lot of which integrate quite seamlessly with QuickBooks Online as well. Now, if you're using QuickBooks Payments to collect, that's the credit card option within QuickBooks, though the full amount of the payment will come through and match, and those separate fees will come through as well. So hopefully you haven't wasted time watching this video. But if you need any help looking at what might be a good system for your business, or you're getting this working, by all means, reach out. And if this video was helpful, click like, subscribe to my channel, and I'll see you next time. Cheers.